Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to what I hope to be a full playthrough. It all depends on the game itself. It's based on vampires and masquerades, and it has bloods in it, and I'm sure there's lions somewhere around there, I don't know. It's one of my all-time favorite games. It has a tendency to crash and fuck up a lot, so there's gonna be problems there. Keep in mind, there's no sparkles, there's no dancing in the daylight, there's no going to being emo at schools. This is basically a vampire game about brutality and blood. This is Vampire the Masquerade Bloodlines, my personal all-time favorite game of all time. I know this game more or less from, like, memory. You can tell me where you are. I could tell you where to go just by talking. Like, oh, you're at that place. Oh, you need to go blah, 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 blah. Anyway, I'm gonna attempt to play through 100% of this. I say hope, because I have a tendency to just go, like, on a space bar. Yes, because of... I'm so used to doing it because I myself know the dialogue, so I'm like, I don't want to be here longer than necessary. Anywho, let's get going. I'm gonna speed through a few things, like I'm... Come on, you can do this, you can load, I believe in you. This is us. I named him Mandy, because why not? Bruja, Gangrel, Malkavian, Nosferatu, Toreador, Tremir, Ventru. Okay. First character I ever played was this guy, because he's the kind of guy who, should I put it, like, easily bullshit his way past things, essentially. He's kind of cool. First thing I won the game with was this guy, because I honestly don't know. Oh, I think I remember. He has Fortitude, which basically makes you, it's a shield. So that was helpful. Let's see, this guy is kind of cool because he has blood magic. He has a pretty cool ability, I'll go through all this later, don't worry about it, called Thaumaturgy. This is blood, level 1 is Blood Strike. It costs 1 blood and it basically shoots, it goes, it's kind of like shooting someone with blood. And if you remain, like it says, like if you remain still and the victim lives, the blood shot will be returned, blah blah blah. It's helpful. And if clever, you can actually shoot people over and over and without losing blood. I mean, you will lose a small smidgen of blood, but that's what happens. I'm thinking I should play this guy. I think I will. Should I? Yeah, why not? Fuck it. Okay, you're gonna name him Mandy. This is all the things you can do. And yeah, be back later. I'll just fix this first. Alright, this is what I have at the moment. But I have in Thaumaturgy there is Purge, which is essentially blood puke. Do you not want that? It's blood puke! Come on! So that's about it. This is my little setup here. You can't see the top here because my face is probably in the way. But it's like 4 in an arm, 2 melee, 3 defense, blah blah. Ranged is not really necessary. You can still buy the weapons, you're just gonna suck with them. I don't know. I'm basically just going in like fists, pretty much. Alright, now what follows is gonna be a long ass cutscene. Brace yourselves, here we go. Enjoy.
Kindred, my apologies for disrupting any business or interfering with prior engagements you may have had this evening. It's unfortunate that the affair that gathers us together tonight is a troubling one.
We are here because the laws that bind our society, the laws that are the fabric of our existence, have been broken. As prince, I am within my rights to grant or deny the kindred of this city the privilege of siring. Many of you have come to me seeking permission, and I have endorsed some of these requests. However, the accused that sits before you tonight was not refused permission. Indeed, my permission was never sought at all. They were caught shortly after the embrace of this child. It pains me to announce the sentence, as up to tonight I considered the accused a loyal and upstanding member of our organization. But as some of you may know, the penalty for this transgression is death. Know that I am no more adjudicator than I am a servant to the law that governs us all. Let tonight's proceedings serve as a reminder to our community that we must adhere to the code that binds our society, lest we endanger all of our blood. Forgive me. Let the penalty commence. Which leads to the fate of the ill-begotten progeny. Without a sire, most children are doomed to walk the earth never knowing their place, their responsibility, and most importantly, the laws they must obey. Therefore, I have decided that
this is bullshit!
If Mr. Rodriguez would let me finish. I have decided to let this kindred live. They shall be instructed in the ways of our kind and be granted the same rights. Let no one say I am unsympathetic to the plights and causes of this community. I thank you all for attending these proceedings, and I hope their significance is not lost. Good evening. Your sire, tragic, my apologies. But you see, there is a strict code of conduct that all of us must adhere to if we wish to survive. When anyone breaks these laws, they undermine the well-worn fabric of our centuries-old society. Understand my predicament. Allowing you to live makes me directly responsible for your subsequent behavior. So, what I'm offering is not generosity, but the opportunity to transcend the fate woven by your sire. This is your trial. You will be brought to Santa Monica. There you will meet an agent by the name of Mercurio. He will provide the details of your labor. I've shown you great clemency. Prove it was more than a wasted gesture, fledgling. Don't come back until you do. Good evening.
And that, ladies and gentlemen, is our intro. No, you can't skip it. I've tried. There is a thing you can do. You go into like config files and do stuff there, but for some reason it doesn't work. Don't know why. Anyway, moving on. This is us. For some reason, it always starts you in first person mode. Little bit of a problem, really. Hold on, I need to do this. This is getting too warm. There we go. Alright. Us, this is us. We can't really turn around, I don't think. And or whatever. Alright. Let's go.
What a scene, man. Woo-wee. Look at this poppy out here like a naked baby in the woods. How about that? Look, you know, it's probably a lot for you to take in, so let me show you the ropes. What do you say?
Here's the point where you can actually skip the entire tutorial if you know what you're doing. Like, meaning like, if you don't want to do the tutorial, you don't have to. By the way, if you're wondering why I'm keep clicking the mouse, it's because I have this little screen you see here. On my view, I see that as well as like a preview, which is why I know where the screen goes, and it keeps freezing on me. So I have to reset it by clicking like middle mouse button. So, like, from my point of view, gone, appeared, gone, appeared, gone, appeared. So like, I don't know. Anyway, I don't know why I felt the need to tell you, but it looks weird whenever I reach over here and click stuff. Anyway, who are you?
I'm Jack. What's important is I'm offering help. You make it back from Santa Monica with your high and we'll trade life stories, okay?
Cool, great. I'm gonna skip stuff when it's not important, because otherwise we're gonna be here for like, in one city for like 4 hours or something. I don't need much time, just give me the basics, I don't care. Yeah, whatever. Yep, absolutely, yep, this is all really important. Trust me on this. Okay, see ya, bye. See ya.
Hello, LA. You're up late.
First you do, you shut her up, and then you take all the blood in here. There we go, and we go into here, we grab that quickly, and grab this thing, greatest toilet in the world. We can turn that guy on, but we don't want to. That's our password, I already know, that's a side quest, there's money in the box, ta-da. And then we go into email, we type in sunrise, there, one, and I always delete them, but I don't know why, it's just something I do. There we go, probably didn't get to read all that, but whatever. Boop. There's a side quest. Let's see if I can do this little trick you can do out here. Hold on. Let's see here. Come on. Ah, yes. I don't know why that's important, but like you can access that bomb in the background, you can see there. Down there. He actually talks to you as you get out the door, like, hey, mister, got any money? Kind of thing, like a bum does. You can skip that by doing that. I don't know, that's not important. It's not a cool skip, it's just something I learned, so, by watching random videos. Okay, quick thing. There's several movements you can do here. Some of them I'm good at, others, most of them not. Let's see if I can make him talk. Nope, good. One is you strafe across the world by looking in a different direction, like you have to look in a specific direction and just hold in your strafe button. For instance, now I am strafing, holding A, strafing left, and W at the same time, and you look up, like that moves you faster. Don't know why. Also, I should have mentioned women travel faster. No idea why. You can also, so I don't think it's very, I can't really do it, but you can bunny hop. Again, I can't do that, but whatever. There's certain other small things you can do, but whatever. First of all, indeed. Let's talk to you.
Yes, is there something I can?
Absolutely. What are you doing?
Waiting for that blasted tow truck.
That's fantastic. I'm sorry to trouble you, but I need money.
Oh, I
thank you. Good. Fantastic. Okay. Basically skipping, like I said, like these people are not important. Like this guy, he's the pawn guy, he's not important at all. We basically need that, and that is it. Now we barely have any money, and we leave. We need to hit up Mercurio. There's a cool thing you can actually do here. I'll show you real, no I don't.
Well,
basically, you know what, fuck it, we'll go in here. Yes? Yes. Yes, we will. Oh, right. That's one I forgot to tell you. If you go strafing AD, 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 oh, you go left, right. You basically, like, do that. You move faster as well. This is basically probably the way I will be doing things.
I'm dying here.
Neat. I'm assuming you're the guy.
Yeah. You're looking for the astrolite?
Uh-huh. Interesting, cool, great. Stay with me, what happened? Yep. Don't worry about that part. It's a broken bottle, now tell me what happened.
Goddamn chemist.
Uh-huh.
Can't trust any operators in LA.
Nope.
I verified him. Organization seem reliable.
Uh-huh.
Guy mixes up speed, his crew sells it.
Ooh.
Occasionally does explosives. I set up a drop.
Right.
I show up at the beach with the money, right?
Yes.
Four of these guys, they come out of nowhere. junky bricks hit me with a bat.
Ow.
It feels like I got a friggin' horse kicking it.
Looks like it's been kicked a couple times. Fantastic. Vamp blood, basically. He's. I should have done that before I got in here. But whatever. I'll show you later. Vamp blood is not important.
Those small-time sons of bitches live out in a dump on the beach.
Well, fantastic. How do I get there? Yes, I need to, I know where it is. Yeah, I know. Anything else I can do to you? For you, whatever. I'll bring something back for you. Yeah. Oh, sorry. I didn't mean to skip that part. Basically, don't tell anyone, please, dear Lord in heaven, oh God. Essentially, is what he's saying there. Don't. Like, you, I don't know if you see this in the edit, but for me, it's very skippish. Like, like a smidge, a little bit. And I'm still recording like 120 FPS. I don't know. So, we need to go here. We need to talk to that jerk off. I don't like him. See if you can tell why. I'm gonna play everything here. From beginning to end, alright? And see if you can figure out why I don't like this man.
Oh man, you're a vampire, aren't you?
Let's say I am. What's it to you?
Hell yeah! Oh man, I knew it! I knew you were, I just could tell, oh man, this is great! And I saw your teeth and I was like, damn, it was like I could just sense you. The name's Knox Harrington. Pleasure to meet you. Oh man.
I don't like his attitude. It's like, oh man! Like, he speaks like he's in a... basically hippie. Okay, let's get this out of the way. I hate hippies. Done. Alright. You're a vampire, how do you know all this? You can also be an ass to him, but if you want XP, I recommend you stay on his good side, because it's side quests. Ah, we will be getting there, don't worry about it. You're a vampire, how do you know this? This is the explanation for the vamp blood and such. And vampires are real and such.
Well, the way it was explained to me, whenever a vampire lets a human drink some of their vampire blood, the human gains a little vampire power. Can heal up quick and that kind of stuff. Jeez.
Oh, rain, really?
Ooh, watch out.
Yep, that's essentially it. Like, you drink vamp blood as a human, you sort of get a little boost, like a vitality boost, like an energy drink with a pedigree. Like, that's about it. That's pretty cool. You seem to be enjoying it.
It's awesome! Man, after that first date, the vampire blood, it's like the best drug. I'm telling you, it's like, well, it didn't mess me up. It just made me feel like I was better at everything. I felt like a god just sucking on that nasty dude's wrist.
Just water today, sadly. Who was this nasty dude? Fair enough.
Really cool to be talking to you. Just, well, because I don't
get sure it is.
Chance to talk to vampires. Oh, man. Well, other than my master, so I thought I'd just say, you know, what's up? You know?
Fair enough. If you look at it from his perspective, that's sort of fine. So what are you doing around here, then?
Look, I probably shouldn't tell you this, but I'm on a secret mission for my master. Well, hey, it's been great talking to you, man. But I better be going. Oh,
well, don't. I mean, if you want to, go right ahead. Your choice. Anyway, I'm gonna say see you around because I kind of want to keep this guy. And no, I need. Excuse me. Oh, there's a way you can get her out of the way. Hold on. It works literally on everybody. I can show you. Hold on. Yep, there he goes. Can I get him in the alley? Hold up. No. Ah, oh, I almost said something really bad there. Let's get in here. Hello, gentlemen. All right, sweetie.
Please wait your turn, and you'll be seen.
Just. I'm here to work on the network thing upstairs.
Nobody told me to expect any technicians.
Well, your driver complex has a security niggle in the IP routing matrix.
Fine. stairs are down the hall. Tell the guard upstairs you're here to work on the network.
Excellent! I just hope I'm in time to salvage the This is brilliant stuff! Like, as an IT guy myself, I'm like, this is brilliant. Alright, important note. The thing we talked about with Knox, that's important for this room. It's not, this room isn't important, but the lady here. She goes like that. She basically a lot of us better skip all that. Feed her your blood. Like he said, remember? If a human sucks on your wish, he gets regenerative powers and he gets things like that, so ta-da. If you don't talk to him, you don't get to do that. Like that best care in the world. Yep. Yep, I did a thing. No, I wanted to help. Don't worry about it. Yes, I absolutely, dude. It's fine. Okay, don't worry. I must be going. Goodbye.
I just need some rest.
So don't we all? I forgot to sell my things at Tripp's pawn shop. Oh, bummer. I'm probably gonna be needing. Where's my blood buff? Blood buff essentially is your pedigree. Like I said, like. Probably gonna be needing it here because I don't think I upgraded this because I'm an idiot. That's how I work. There, and we want to get on here and go to email. Was it? Fuck. Yeah, I remembered something. Those are all passwords, but for different computers. Tonight, keep in mind, I'm gonna pause slightly on these. And then the next. And then the next. And then the next. And then the next. Whatever. Okay. Keep that. That's actually quite, I should put it like, interesting for this room in particular. Specifically, this guy. Yo!
I'm sorry, sir, but you're going to have to wait outside like...
Yeah. I'm assuming you're Malcolm. Your wife know you about your affair?
Get out of here.
No. Don't you see I'm with a patient? Well, this is kind of important. Divorce is expensive. I'm asking for a few hundred... Wow. Guess I don't care if your wife finds out then. Like, it doesn't matter to me.
Trying to blackmail me?
Well... A little bit.
She wouldn't believe you. Now get out.
I'll go ask her forward that email from Paige. To this address. I like the fact that it's .vtm. That's excellent.
Wait now.
75? Yeah, I got 75.
But I'm in the middle of something.
Whatever. Put it in the mailbox. And then I will eat you. He actually is here all the time and he refills some blood, so you have your own personal like medic blood, essentially. Okay. One thing we need to do here, there we go, and then we can go up here. I'm gonna pre-do a few things here. Don't worry about it, it's fine, it's totally fine. There, we open that, get around, thank you. Now, strafe the walls. If you're getting motion sick, not much I can do about that, sorry. A little bit, but not really. Thinking. Nothing on this side, okay. So, these are prostitutes, if you couldn't figure it out. We need to go to beach access. Two dudes are gonna talk here, but it's not important. They talk about the pier, we're gonna be seeing that part, don't worry about it. It'll be fine. Here we go. Yep. Here's the thing I thought about showing you. If you go here first, before you head to Mercurio, you actually skip this dialogue.
Up there, through that chain link gate and up those stairs.
Thanks, bye. She's a psychic. You can skip that dialogue, I don't know, that's not, again, not really impressive or important, but whatever.
Listen, it's like I've told you types about 1,000 times now. We know we can't hunt around here, alright?
Whatever. What are you talking about?
You mean you ain't here to run us off?
No, why would you think that?
I'm getting pretty sick of it.
Well, shit. Why?
I don't know. We all seem to have come down with the same disease.
Well, thin bloods. Okay, I'm new to this myself. What's a thin blood?
I'm damned if I know. Well, know you don't want to be one. You seem to be in the lead. You tell me.
No, no. How did this happen to you?
I just come to town for the surf tourney. Seems like years ago. It's
side quest.
About 6 months now. Every night during the finals, I used to hit the local diner after the beach parties fizzled out in the AM. That's where I met her.
Who?
She had a natural beauty.
Don't they all?
Plastic dolls littering the sand. Her name was Lily. I remember introducing myself. The way she seemed grateful for the company. Well, a few nights after our meeting, we were on the beach alone.
Whoa, look at the time. I gotta go.
She tried to tell me what she
I want the XP.
I didn't understand. And so she showed me.
Wow.
Furious with her when I took it all in. I cursed her and left, never really knowing what I was. I realize now how she must have felt. So here I am now.
Well, that's a shame. Basically, like, what are you? I'm a vampire. What do you mean? Like that. Like, here's an idea. Show him your fangs. I mean, people have prosthetic teeth and shit, but it's a start. Say, like, I suck blood. Like, what does that mean? And then you can absolutely go ahead because it's a fucking idiot. But still, I'm assuming she's dead.
Clinically, yes. But honestly, I don't know. I suppose I'd have moved on by now if I didn't think she'd show up one of these nights. There's a lot I've got left to say to her.
Well, you know you're vampires though, right?
That's what Lily tried to tell me. But what I don't understand are the rules and well, the terms and the reasons some of them are at our throats claiming we're harbingers of the apocalypse.
Well,
that's what I want to know.
I'm assuming these people are as well?
Aye. Most of them just recently arrived in LA. Chased off by the Sabbath or some such thing from their home cities. More in the dark than I am.
Well, that's... Lunch, but... Yeah, well, that's a shame. Maybe I should look into this thing.
I hope you had better luck than I did. No one's been particularly friendly to me in this city. Only reason we're in such...
Yeah, that's absolutely terrible. Okay. Another thing we need to do... There he is. There's another...
Tragedy. Trouble.
Shh. This guy. This guy's kind of funny. Who doesn't? Just play an ass.
If the head vampire dies, we all become human again, right?
Only if he's killed with a holy stake, sure. You know, I tend to have one on me. Would you be interested in purchasing it?
Okay, but first I have another question. How about blood transfusions? If I get a full blood transfusion, I can become human again, right?
Only if it's unicorn blood, though.
Unicorn blood?
Look, there can be vampires, but no such thing as unicorns. Are you sure about this one?
I'll buy it.
Cool, great.
I'm gonna go get some money,
Absolutely. Move. Thank you. First off, we need the holy stake, which is a piece, little bit of a log. And then we go up the stairs. Hey, buddy. Alright. Now we need to head up to the pier in order to solve a part of a very long quest. Like, most of these quests are takes forever to clear up. But first, we need to head up here. There used to be a thing here. It's not here anymore. Anyway, it used to be in the release version, where there was a gum. You can sell him a lot more shit to get more money out of him. That was kind of funny. Anyway. Hi. Can I eat you? No. Better not, I'm gonna say. There's also games in here, like River Raid, don't think I played it. Blood Quest, no. Pitfall I played, it's pretty fun. Call of Duty Pinball, and then there's a lot of things. Alright. Now we need to head back down to the beach. There we go. Also, you're supposed to be able to, like, strafe in it. This is it's basically a speedrun thing. It's open, but I know, but... Ah, fuck it. You're supposed to be able to jump over there. I've never been able to do it. Here's one thing you can do, though. If you stand here, look up, and you... Hold on. Ta-da! Don't know why that's... Again, it's not impressive. It's just dumb. Basically, if you stand under here and jump and crouch a lot... Because... Hold on. You see here? You see that? You see the part where he sort of... He juts up. That counts as a full person, so it's a little bit weird like that. Okay. So, I want to get a lot of things from you. Or do I? Nah. Let's do it the fun way. Haha! Dorks! And we're done. Excellent job, if I may say so myself. Yep. Aim! Oh, fuck! Almost had him. Okay. This guy can actually be talked to now.
Do you have any of those items you mentioned?
Absolutely. Here's a stake.
Yeah. Here you go. Now, where can I find the head back?
Here's where it can be a little funny. Tallest building downtown, LaCroix. His name is Nines. He's probably downtown. Can't you figure out? It's the President of the United States! Say LaCroix, because why not? He's basically supposed to say this, like, we won't be able to live like this anymore. I'm going to kill the head vampire. And then he sort of does that. That's about it. Now we need to head back to our friend who's bleeding to death. Alright. Boop. Hey, buddy! What's up? You dead? I brought you some morphine. Hold still. Yeah, you needed that. You're welcome. I got the Astrolite as well. Yes. Nah. Nah. Yep, that's a shame. Like I said, I'm skipping past things you don't need to know. What am I supposed to do now? Well, let's actually do this one. It's kind of interesting.
That Astrolite? Twice as powerful as TNT. Instant demolition. Be on the other side of the world when you engage that timer. You need to make someplace disappear. A warehouse. Looks to be a Sabbat interest.
Sabbat are the low-life vampires, kind of like thugs, essentially. Like, that's about it. Okay, how do I find this place?
There's a guy. I never met him, but I heard a lot about him. His name is Tong.
Tong. Bertram Tong.
He's one of you types. If there's anyone who knows more than me about this city, it's him.
Mm-hmm.
Unfortunately, Tong's hiding out at the moment.
Because of?
Tong's laying low because of Therese.
Therese Vormen. Therese Voorhees Vorman.
I don't know the details. Mike takes the tongue, thinks he's about to get whacked, so he's gone underground till Therese calls it off.
Well.
If you want to put that warehouse into orbit anytime soon, you're going to have to get Therese to call off the feud.
That's not going to be a problem.
She and his sister Jeanette, they run the asylum. Some freaky customers frequent that place.
Mm-hmm.
Try not to do business there.
Good point, man. You can ask questions if you want. I won't, because that's just going to take forever. Because it's so much to... I highly recommend you actually check out everything, because it's actually quite interesting. I'm just not gonna do it in this video, because it would take me forever! But I recommend you actually check it out. Because why not, I guess. Hold on, my brain is... Right, we need to go over to this side. Nope, this side. And keep heading this way. This is the safest way I know how to transport myself. This wall strafing is the only one I can do rather decently. And the side strafing thing, like blah 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 blah. We need to head over here. That quest we picked up on the beach. Boop. Don't pay that guy no mind. Don't worry about it. We'll be fine. Alright.
What'll it be?
The cream's candles, I can smell it. And you think those are rat droppings there?
You're the health inspector.
Let me just get my badge out and I'll show you.
You know, at least the last health inspector had a decent...
Yeah, that's great. Give me the money. Thank you. Now, we need to talk to her again. Ever seen any pale, kind of strange types here late at night?
Is that a trick question?
Have you ever heard this? I'm basically fast-forwarding. Have you ever seen blood? Try to remember, where did you hear it?
I know I've heard that before.
I know you did. Maybe that's kind of strange, prettiest thing.
Oh, that girl. Nice girl.
Mm-hmm.
First decent human being I've seen in here for years. Not like all the junkies and crazies I normally see. Yeah.
Yeah, that's a shame.
So hungry, too. Just sat there all night with a full glass of water in front of her, talking about this and that.
Yeah, she's very lonely. I'll do that. Great, fantastic. Now we have her journal. Or no, not the journal. Information, basically. Like, if you don't know what you do, you have her her license thing. This is what she looks like. And you have you can look her up over in this direction. Don't worry about it. We're gonna go into this. Kilpatrick's bail bonds. That'll make sense in a second. Don't worry about it. First off, we need to turn off this lady, because she doesn't shut up. Then this is Kilpatrick.
Welcome to Kilpatrick's
Waiting for our beanbag. My name's Arthur Kilpatrick. How can I help you? You run this place. You can stop kissing my ass, fat boy. Like, come on, he's helpful.
Yep, sure do. I'm a third generation bondsman.
Got cool.
Employees, but I handle most every aspect of the business.
Neato. How's business? You looking for help?
Well, I can't seem to find my damn bounty hunter Carson. It's pissed me off, to be honest. I need him to go find someone. Since I'm stuck here, why don't you go look for him?
Cool, absolutely. Why should I look for him?
Great. I suppose the first place you should look is his apartment.
The Manica RP's one, I think it is. Maybe you'll find something there that'll let you know where he's got himself into. It's a key card to let you in. Like, that's how fast I can read, so. Okay, cool, great, fantastic. And then you go up and check her face. Lily. You go into here. What's her name? Like, Lily something, I guess. You just type things. I already know where she is. Crazy person not talking today? That's a bummer. Alright, so. Let's see here. Thinking. My brain stopped again. It tends to do that a lot. It's a real bummer. We need to go in here. And find a red car on the other side of that wall. There it is. That one. The pretty looking one. Open this. Get a bunch of things that you need one of, and then you click this. You just scroll through. You can read it if you want to. I won't. And then we need to head to the hospital again. To that nice lady. Yes. Over here. Hopefully this place in the back is now unlocked. Is it? I don't think it is. Yes, it is. Sweet. Alright, now we don't go upstairs. We go downstairs. We're gonna talk to Jerkoff McDouchebag. He has an attitude. I want to kick him in the face. He's just bad. Okay.
You next up for the needle?
Your donation can save a life, you know.
Oh.
But isn't it a little late for altruism?
I don't think.
No, I'm not here to be offering. Yep, absolutely. How much?
If you have.
I need to get into the back room. But that's a shame. It's okay. Queen bitch gave her okay. Go ahead and call her. Go ahead, call. Ha! You dork. That's not the one. That's the one. Now we can open this one from this side. That's how that works. Then you can, if you want to, go in here and get the code out of this guy. But I already know the code.
Is it 1969, okay? What cross you say? It's not a year for me and you. It's not a year with nothing to do.
That's a hint on what the code is. There we go. Click this. This opens. Thanks. This is her. Now I'm gonna see her. Does it work? Yes, game saved. Awesome. That's great. Now, this lady is okay, but what happens afterwards tends to lock up. So pray for me. I'm sure you do. What happened?
Let me go. It's painful. Like I'm going to die.
Whatever. Hold still. I'll let you go. This part you can't skip. What? What? No, you don't.
Oh, sweet mother of God.
Pretty sure that's not how a neck works, but whatever. Check her neck movement here. That's how necks work. Oh, good, she didn't lock.
It's never been so satisfying. All of it. I drank until I heard his heart stop, and I was sucking on a dry, dead artery. It was euphoric. But I've killed him. I've never killed anyone before. What happened? What came over me?
The beast took over. No. Be nice to her, trust me. Calm down, tell me who you are.
What just happened?
I don't know. Nope.
Never done anything like that before.
Of course you haven't.
I'm not a monster.
Nope, you're not. Absolutely not. It's fine. It's totally fine.
I tried to steal some blood. I heard they sold it. I was hungry, and I can't hunt in town. They caught me, and I was trapped. Thought I'd never escape, but...
Cut! Do, redo! I was trapped! Like, that line is like... I mean, it's cool because she seems panicked and it's great, but you can tell it's a fuck up. Come on.
My name is Lily.
E told me about you.
E?
Yeah.
You know E?
Indeed, I do. I said I'd help him. What do you know about Thinbloods?
I tried to tell E about his condition, but he was so furious at me for what I'd made him into, he wouldn't listen. A Thinblood, from what I've been told, is a vampire whose blood is weaker than most.
Go on.
Rolf, my sire, told me some vampires consider Thinbloods a bad omen and want them destroyed. Rolf wasn't a Thinblood, and apparently I am. I don't know why. Rolf abandoned me. His group wouldn't take me in. They said I was a liability. He left me with so many questions.
Absolutely. You should go see him. He forgives you. You know he does not. Okay, great. Bye. Yep. Yeah, it's fine. It's totally fine. It's fine. It's fine. It's fine. It's fine. Please. Please don't fuck it up. Oh, yes. Because why not? Dickhole. Why don't you pay your man things? Why don't I pay you anymore? Wow. I don't need your blood. I know you, how you're getting it.
That's interesting. You like to talk, don't you?
Tell me a horrible story. Basically, if you do that, he can sell your blood again, but we don't care. You can't get into him. I've tried many, many, many times. Get closer. Thank you. You can basically manhandle him as... And he gets back to you. Come on. Ah, he moved. Shit. All right. Now that we've got that out of the way, we can actually go back to the beach and tell people about things. But first, we need to head over in this direction. We need to head over to Mercurius' apartment for that bounty hunter job. All right. Go into here. Play that if you want to, doesn't matter. So we need that and that.
McGee.
Imalia.
There was no sign of McGee.
Location.
I
done.
I updated the file
and I got out before it finished. Awesome. So, if you've been paying attention, he's basically, McGee is supposed to be over in this direction with the, in the tattoo parlor. I'm basically doing quests that are nearby, so don't worry about it. It's fine. All is fine. No one here. Shame. And, there it is. Wait, what was it? Tattoo gun! My god. Does every place here have to look shit? Like, really? Mr. McGee? He doesn't seem to be here at the moment. Can I help you?
Well, I'm not sure.
I had an appointment with him a few days ago.
But he never seemed to show up.
Do you know when he'll return? No, I don't actually. What sort of appointment was this?
Well, Mr. McGee was going to be doing some modeling for me.
This is a good quest.
Medical reference for the work that I do here in the studio.
Hmm. Oh dear. Maybe I could come down and model for you, I guess.
Why, yes, that sounds delightful. Perhaps you could come down to my studio and we can sort out the details.
Sounds good. Where are you located?
I'm at the end of Main Street, small basement studio. The sign says Gimbal's Prosthetics.
Neat, sounds good. I'll be there in a little while. Right. It's basically like you can do this quest all in one swoop, basically, so let's go do that. So we basically need to head all the way down here and then to the right in order to get to Mr. Gimbal, who's a little below. If you couldn't tell by his fucking weird ass voice. So we need to head down here. Come on. There we go.
Yes, may I help you?
Hello, I spoke on the phone a little while ago.
Oh, right.
Yeah, fantastic. Good, thanks. Gimbal! Notice something odd with the man? Hmm? This guy, I am actually... Let's see, oh, it's just that thing. Okay, cool. So... I don't think I've ever noticed this one. 10 easy steps to increase your hourly earnings. Wow. Okay. weird, I haven't noticed that one before. Anyway, this guy I'm actually gonna follow through on the messages on because he gets kind of weird.
Hello! Welcome to Gimbal's Prosthetics and Medical Supplies. You're here for the modeling job? Good, good. You seem to have rather well-developed limbs, if you don't mind me saying so.
Mr. Gimbal.
Oh, yes, forgive me. My name is Gimbal.
Skimble. Stanley Gimbal.
But, dear, let us dispense with formalities. You can call me Stan.
The man. Tell me a little about yourself, Stan.
Me? Oh, I'm just trying to make things a little easier for those who find themselves disadvantaged. Giving a helping hand, you might say. A leg up.
Boo! I seem, you know, disadvantaged yourself.
Hmm? Oh, you mean the arm. Yes, that's an interesting story. If you've got the time for one.
Oh boy, you want to hear this because this guy gets odd.
Well, you might say I have a certain love affair with the human anatomy. An obsession, really. Prosthetics seemed a natural occupation in which to focus my enthusiasm, as it were.
Mm-hmm. And your arm?
Well, I came to realize that I would never truly reach mastery in prosthetics without knowing what it was like to have to use one.
Go on.
And so I decided, quite out of the blue, actually, to cut off my own arm. My work, as you can well imagine, has quite improved since then.
Wow. Like he's quite right in a way. Like you don't know how to prosthetics work unless you have one, but like you could get a second opinion. You can get a guy in the studio to just like, hey, does this work? But there's a reason. There's a reason he does what he does. Don't worry about it. It'll be clear in a few seconds. Don't worry about it. Now that's education. Can we take some pictures now?
Aha! An eager participant. Very good. Just give me a few moments to get my equipment ready.
Check out the fastest guy in the world. And he's gone. There's blood in this. There we go. Free blood's not always a bad move. Like all of this seems fine for like a medical thing, right? Here's his tools. He obviously washes them. It's all fine. You know, here's where he operates on people. Like he may have been a little, it's a little messy, you know. It gets to be like that as a doctor.
Huh? Oh, hey, help! You gotta get me out of here, man. This guy's a freaking nut job.
Who, Gimbal?
Yeah, Gimbal. That guy's been taking pieces off of me and McGee over here for the last 3 days.
Yep.
He's crazy, man. Freaking crazy.
Hold on. Crazy person incoming. Hamina. God damn it. Get up. Ow. Stop face slapping. Slap you in the face. Ow. Dick. In your face, literally. Hi.
Man, you're a lifesaver. I wasn't sure I was gonna make it. I'm telling you, I've been on some weird cases, but this one takes the cake.
Your cards and I take it.
Yeah, that's me. How did you know?
Arthur sent me.
You did?
Uh-huh.
Oh, man, that's solid. I owe that guy big. I hope I can figure out a way to get him back for this.
He's got some work for you.
What? Oh, no, man. No. Not for me anymore. Look at my hand. Gimbal took my trigger finger for a trophy.
Ooh.
I'm all through with this business.
Fair enough.
I hate to leave Arthur in a lurch, but that's just the way it is.
Fair enough, I guess. I understand. See ya. And for those wondering, of course you can keep the arm. Everything seems fine here. Nothing here. Okay, we're leaving. I like that magazine that just says guy. It's a weird one. Also, that's a record player. Huh. Doesn't play anything. It's a shame. Alright. So, basically what we need to do now is head back to the other side. Do we have anything left on this side? Nope. We're done on this side. We need to head all the way back. first order of business, we head into the beach area to finish the quest with Lily and E, because, well, it's right here and it's like on the way, so that's how things will work out. Plus it's like extra XP, and like I mentioned before, I want all the XP because I want to feel like a badass. That's how things are, that's how I want things, that's how things are going to be. Alright. First off.
Hi.
Hi, what's up?
This life's been hard on him, both of us, but he forgives me.
Aww.
Leaving soon.
Good.
I have some family with a place out in the middle of nowhere in Oregon.
Cool.
It should be okay for us to stay out there,
mm-hmm.
as long as we're together.
How are you gonna feed? Have you thought this in have you thought this one out? Vampires in love, you guys make a great airport paperback. Hi, I fixed the thing for you.
You brought my Lily back.
Yes.
She told me all about what happened. I don't know why you helped this, but...
XP.
Your blood's worth bottling.
Don't say that.
Never let her go again. Thank you.
You're welcome.
I'm gonna be getting out of LA soon. Too dangerous here. Rosa told us something big's about to happen, and I don't want to be here when the Jack comes out of the box.
Favorite line coming up. If the shithouse goes up in flames, it'll probably be my fault. See ya. And we're done with it. We're done with this shithole. Huzzah. Alright, now then we head back to the other side again. Great, it's gonna be a lot of running back and forth. Trust me on that. Up the stairs. Come on, up the stairs here we go. Yes. Now we head all the way over to the Asa Kilpatrick. I wanna get all the small shit out of the way for before I start doing the main quest. The main quest is in there. I have a few things to say about how I'll be handling this club in particular. It's gonna be a bit tricky for me, let's say. Gonna be time consuming. But first, let's head off in here to continue this one. Alright.
Hey there. What
Hi, what's up? I found a thing. He's got his trigger finger popped.
Man, that's a tough one. Bounty Hunter ain't no goat without his trigger finger.
This is true.
That really leaves me in hot water, boy. Gonna cost old Arthur real good.
Can you pay me?
Oh, yeah. Sorry about that. Here you are.
Thanks. You were saying?
I got this guy with a sheet a mile long. Put in on three warrants.
Uh-huh.
His girlfriend put up for the bond and now he missed the court date. I can't get in touch with either of them. Want a job?
Absolutely.
Well, it won't be much of a job since you ain't licensed and all, but until I can get me another bounty hunter, I need you to find out if this guy skipped town or what.
So you just want me to find him if he's here or not?
Yeah, no body attachment or nothing. Just find out if he's here or where he went. I'll pay you. Deal?
Absolutely.
Great. All right. The guy's name is Mike Durbin. Goes by the name Muddy. His girlfriend put up for his bond. She lives over there above Tripp's Pawn Shop. Her name is Marion Murrieta, but I haven't been able to get in touch with her.
Shame. You can ask if you want to get a gun, but guns aren't necessary. Don't worry about it. So let's head over.
That's right. Marion Murrieta. In them crappy...
Yeah, that's fantastic. I hear you.
All right.
Cool, great. Let's go. So, now we have that done. And let's see... I need to look at this because beginnings. We can't do these yet. Yep. We need to head over to our apartments now, sadly. Here we are. First, we need to get the thing from Malcolm. And then we head upstairs. No. This one. And boop. And there's another quest we can do now. Can I use it? Yes, I can. Peeping is what? Sneaking. Sweet. Click
here. Mike, look. I gotta head downtown for a few days. Maybe.
Yeah, that's a shame.
Reno calls. They'll meet me down there. We got something to discuss. I'll be at Milton's place. Skyline Lofts 2A. Sorry, baby. I'll explain everything later.
Another quest. This is in the hospital, And as I said before, I'm gonna do that one right away because it's not that difficult. Just get there and yeah, that's about it. Have I been in here? There's nothing of use in here. No idea why this room is open. Whatever. I got stuck on nothing there. That's amazing. All right. Back into the hospital again. Good lord. And this is where our little talk with lady before comes into play. Because now that we had the key, we unlocked it. And she said, hey, tell the guard you're here to fix things. We don't need to go sneaky because of this guy. That's not at all what I wanted to do. Hi. What? 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 Excuse me? Excuse you? What the hell? How are we doing here? That went to shit immediately. Okay, that was bad. That was really bad, actually. Yeah. That went really poorly. Excuse me for a second. And we're back. Do we have aspects? Yes. We can't really see him. This is good. Can I just get in here? Go, 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 yes. Boop. Get up the thing. There. Good. Okay. Bang, 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 bang. Now we need to head in here. Okay, now let's see if I can remember things. CS door. Fuck. Fuck. Optometry is the other room. Yes. Unlock. CS safe. Sorry for bumping the mic. Is it this one that is? Yes. Unlock. Ask me how many times I played this game. Unlock. There we go. Now we need to wait for guy to come by, essentially, so bear with me. There we go. Go around the corner, sweetie. Okay, that is good. Ah, shit. That is less good. Now he's over there instead. Can I possibly... see if this still works. This is where we need to go. Where does this go? Where does this lead? Where in the hell? What the fuck? Huh. Okay. Oh, we're back here. Neato. All right. Oh, we're all the way back here. Neat. We can't open that yet. Go in here, we can do. There's nothing else important. All right, back upstairs. Okay, we're back in here. Neato, okay. So there's nothing we can do up here. He was out here. Isn't he? Where is he? I'm scared when I don't know things. Okay, I'm going here then. Right. Panacea. but it'll be fine. We need to also do this. Go into camera. Tometry. Yep. Camera one for the room we're gonna go in. Are you already here? Is he already out there? Let's find out. Yep, he's still there. Shit. Okay. Good. Now we have to wait for him to leave. Rather quickly, actually. Now, if we're quick here. Goodbye. Ta-da. Now we head all the way back to our apartment so we can actually turn this in. And I will show you the fastest mail delivery you've ever seen. Click this, get the blood, which is that one, give it, go outside, and then head back in again. Money! But you still need to head upstairs and get on your computer in order to get the quest done, essentially. Nicely done. Neato. Now we can leave, I think. Sort of. Alright. Boop. First stop, this one of course. What's up? Information.
So what'd you find out about Muddy?
He is not here.
Alright then. I'll have to call in some bounty hunters to help me find Muddy and a couple of other jumpers. Thanks for all your help.
You can thank me in American dollars.
Sorry about that. Here you are.
Thank you, sir.
See you around then.
Sure. Alright, now we need to head outside. And now we're done with... Yes. We're done with all the quests we can actually do here. Side quests we can do here. We can now go in and do the head missions. And this is where things are going to be tricky because all the clubs play licensed music. I believe the band in here like Chasm or C-H-I-A-S-M or something like that. Yes, whatever. I don't like the song, but whatever. So I'm gonna have to skip it, but the voices from the game are stored in the game folder, so I'm gonna have to put those pieces together, essentially. So, but I'm just gonna do that for the important people. Like, there's some people in here you don't need to hear about, so I'm gonna try that out. Pray for me. Here we go. There we go. Hopefully I have remembered to take out the game audio now. So, you ready for the first... Hold on, I need to do this as well. There we go. Hi, what's up? Alright, here we go. It's not the fact that I'm nervous about the gameplay, it's the fact that I have to edit this. Okay, here we go.
Ooh, what do we have here? Another scrumptious young plaything straight out of life and into my club? You smell new, little boy. Like fabric softener do on freshly mowed AstroTurf. Ooh, I'm not frightening you, am I, duckling?
If you have seduction here, which I should have had by now, but I'm an idiot, you can actually speak to her in a way she understands, essentially, like, aren't you equipped with a nice pair of fun bags? That's not what you say, but you know what I'm talking about.
I'm the finger down your spine when all the lights are out. I'm the name on all the men's room walls. When I pout, the whole world tries to make me smile, and everyone always wants to know who is that girl.
Aren't you a tease? Got a name I can remember you by?
I am Jeanette. And this bit of chaos crammed in a certifiable giggle is my club. I just love to give you funny feelings all night, sweetheart, but I really must trouble with some business. We'll reunite Sweden soon, I promise.
Soon can't be soon enough. Please don't get stuck. Oh, thank God. There's usually people there who can actually stand in her way, so she sort of goes like... Like, all the time, like, you have to reload everything. Now, we have Nox as well! Yay! Quests!
Hey, man!
Hey, Nox, what's going on?
Yeah, not much. I'm just waiting around for my master.
The master you couldn't talk about?
Okay, okay. I guess I can tell you about him.
Yay.
Oh, man! His name's Bertram Tongue! He's a
Nosferatu. Ah! No kidding! Small world! I'm looking for the guy!
Oh, man! I wish I knew where he was.
I know where he is.
Getting antsy waiting around for him. I need to tell him some stuff, you know?
We've actually seen the place.
Or anything. Oh, man, I... Whenever he needs me, just, you know, appears.
Oh, okay. What did you need to tell him?
Oh, man. Wow. Bertram had me keeping an eye on this guy. This Asian dude who's been poking around Santa Monica. Bertram thought he might be a vampire or something like a vampire.
I don't know. So what's the problem then?
Oh man, this guy, this thing got wise to me.
Jackass.
Now instead of me watching him, he's watching me, you know?
Booga, booga, booga.
I see this guy appear around me all the time, like off in the distance watching me. He'll warp up next to me. Oh man, and disappear.
Spooky. Want me to take care of it?
Hell yeah! Right on! Okay, like I said, he's some kind of Asian vampire thing, mm-hmm. you know? Mm-hmm. The only clue I got is this driver's license that he dropped once while I was tailing him. I've been so freaked out that I haven't even had a chance to check it out.
I'll look into it for you.
Right on! Just come back and let me know the job's done so I can stop freaking out. Oh, man. Maybe I'll see Bertram by then.
Yeah, absolutely. Good for you. Now we talk to this guy to basically let us in. We need to find her. Yep, absolutely. Now, let's just go deal with his little problem, shall we? Yes, we can go do something different and, you know, get me off the hook, shall we say. So I don't have to edit all too much. Because at this point, I'm expecting my future editor self to be in a mess, just like, oh god, why am I doing this? Why am I doing this? Why did I decide this was a good idea? Was it A to F? There. Cram V. Yep, he's basically in the hospital. There we go, need to head to the hospital again. Now that we're in here, we need to head all the way back down. You know that area I was before where I said there's a box locked, but we don't need to open it just yet? That's exactly where we're headed. And it's down in here. Don't get stuck on the things, please don't. There he is. Here's the guy. It's not actually the guy, but there's a corpse there now, so whatever. Success. Mine. There we go. You can't really do anything with any of these. Whoops. Yeah. Something did open, but I don't know why. Okay, cool, I guess. Let's pay a little visit to my... Come on! Get off. There we go. To my little blood bank upstairs to see if he is still a czar. I kind of need it, considering the fact that I'm pretty much empty. Thank you. One side didn't work, but the other did. Brilliant. Alright, he seems fine. But I'm just gonna... Sorry about that. I'm just gonna save just in case. No nurse here to save you. Whoop, and the guy stands up. He tends to do that at times. I don't know why. He just does. And then he just goes... Back to sleep. And there you go. Now. Hold on. Brain. Right. Outside. Outside. Thank you. And then we head outside again. And then we're outside. And we head over here. We head into Foxy Boxes. Over there. This is our main location. This is where it ends. Basically. There's a PC in there you can read shit on if you want to. I don't care. There's the Asian guy! Let's kick his ass. A lot. Fast and hard. Let's go. Which way are you going first? That way. Huh! Huh! He has a crossbow. Watch out for the crossbow. Ow, dick! He has a sword as well. Be careful. Ah! Bad timing. Bad time. Bad times. There we go. Ha, ha, ha. Hiya. Ha ha. Uppercut, bitch. Don't stand in front of him. That's a bad move. What is his name? Kathaya Kathayakaisatiam. Cool. The sad part is you don't get to keep his sword he uses, which I find to be bullshit. Okay, you can't do anything else. Nope, let's leave. Boop. Now we head all the way back to Nox. Yay. Nox.
Yo, dude, you do that thing yet?
I did. You don't have to worry about it anymore.
Oh, thank God. Oh, man. Yes. That thing was hounding me like every night. Look, I still haven't heard anything from Bertram. Sorry, okay? I'll still let him know, but for now, I have no way to repay you.
But that's absolutely fine. See you around, I guess. All right. Music for me is extremely loud. You should be so happy you don't actually. Yeah.
Your city? Last time I looked, it was called Santa Monica, not Stuck Up Bitch. So vulgar. I can't even look at you sometimes, you Jezebel. Oh, Therese, you really do paint a flattering portrait of me with your turn-of-the-century barbs. I always assumed you could do nothing but look down on me. Just the sight of you! The sight of that wicked, painted pout, concealing that dirty, diseased mind! Sin! You have no shame. Let she who is without sin cast the fierce tone. Go ahead and mock me. You pull your pranks, make fun of my ways. It suits you. You're just one big joke. Don't you call me that! Should I start calling a duck a pig as well? I'm your sister. How can you treat me like this? That's it, Jeanette. Run away from the truth. I'll take care of everything, as always.
Thank you. Hello?
Please, come in. I do apologize for my sister's crassness if it made you uncomfortable. She's unabashedly scandalous, but in the club business, I suppose that kind of personality is a necessary evil.
This is fair. I'm just glad she's gone. Stay on her good side. I'm just glad she's gone. You're Therese, I assume.
Therese Vorman, yes. I'm the proprietor of this club, and the only person in this city whose good side it's in your best interest to stay on. What brings you to Santa Monica?
I need you to call off the thing.
Tongue's exile is self-imposed, I assure you. But then, what reason would I have not to hate that loathsome Nosferatu scoundrel? Bloody Nosferatu. They're so unclean.
Your phobias don't concern me. Why do you hate him?
He meddles in my affairs.
Oh, dear.
He's a bad influence on my sister and she on him.
Uh-huh.
If you were in my place, would you let him compromise your authority?
Fair point.
You most certainly would not.
Nope.
I'd quite like it if I never had to hear that name again.
That's a good point, then. Can't you just put out the word you'd gotten feud?
Why would I do that?
Because I
let
said so.
Let him think
so.
I mean to kill him. That way I don't have to worry about him sabotaging everything. Do you realize how his subterfuge makes me look to the Camarilla?
That's unfortunate, but I need to see him.
Tongue and his co-conspirators' actions ruined my chance at partnership in a crucial piece of property. I do have several other promising ventures, and one in particular has been, to say the least, an ordeal. I'd be willing to put the word out that my grievances with Tongue have been swept under the rug, but in return, you'll have to help me remove a particularly burdensome spirit from a property I'm looking to invest in.
Absolutely.
Rumor is that a personal item of a ghost may be used to draw it out or excise it from its haunt.
Mm-hmm.
While I don't put a lot of stock in hearsay, it's my last option.
So all you got.
So I want you to go to the Ocean House Hotel, find an item of the spirits, and bring it back.
I can do that. Absolutely. It's my favorite thing to do, I guess.
Oh, I fully intend to do so. You'll find that dealing with me on the whole is appreciably more predictable than dealing with some of the egomaniacs that are my peers. So long as our business doesn't go sour, my word is gold.
I can respect that, and I appreciate
it. Before I forget, take this. The only way to reach the Ocean House this time of night is through a tunnel in the sewers. You'll need that key to open the gate for that tunnel.
If that's what it takes.
If you'll excuse me, I've got situations to set straight.
Right. Goodbye. And we're leaving. Yay. So, we basically need to head down the sewers, like the lady said. We're gonna go into the best parts of the game. In my opinion, anyway. There we go. Go a little bit faster. Not a lot, but a little bit. I can't bunny hop in this. It's bullshit. All of it is bullshit, I tell you. Bullshit! Yep. Go up here. I wonder where they got the inspiration from. I don't know, can't see it. You can either lockpick it or get the key that's like right in here. Whichever suits your fancy, I guess. We're gonna do it the easy way because I kind of want to keep my blood. Excuse you. Yeah, everything seems fine here. Yep, it's nothing out of the ordinary. I'm used to everything that happens here now. Don't worry about it. It's cool. Spooky. I'm gonna try to show you everything. Also, you kind of want to move fast across these things because otherwise that happens. And this thing. There we go. Let's see if I can show you a trick. Nope. Bummer. You can actually skip this entire thing by just leaping over that, but you have to be quick about it. I mean, I didn't manage to do it this time, but whatever. I was gonna go down here anyway, but I'm just saying. You can do that if you want to. Lady! Excuse you. Poof. Just hit it with my fist. Hotels. Oops. Slowest door. Come on! There, thank you. Okay, this was a dead child's head in a tumbler, so we need to go there. This is one. And boop. Take the key. She sounds like she's somewhere. We need to go down here in order to turn on the power because we need to head upstairs. In order to head upstairs, we need the elevators. Here he comes. Here he comes. You gonna come, buddy? George! No one wants to play with me. That's a bummer. So, here's the thing. We click this, and then you gotta be careful. Or... Ow. That works. It's fine. Totally fine. It's good. I'm fine. And... There it is. Now we can go upstairs. Open, please. Thank you, sweetie. Up! Decent elevator, I mean. Ghost lady again. If I could bunny hop through all this, it would be brilliant. Another body. Still, like, I can't quite put my finger on what they're trying to... Couldn't be a reference to anything specific, could it? I don't know. I could have tripped! Fucking dicks! Let's leave. We're leaving. We're going to meet the ghost girl. Because that's what we do. We need to do, actually. Oh, can I get in here now, thanks. Go to there. Down. Here's another one. There we go. Bop. Go in here. There's several ways to connect. People say you can do this, but this is the way I do it. It's very simple. Hold on. My headphones squishing my ears. Bad move. Okay. Her diary.
Help me.
Indeed. And all of this is gonna go floof. Second. Floof. See, I told you. Told you to go floof. We can't go through there. We're waiting for that thing. Here it goes. Here it goes. Here it goes. Ta-da. And then we jump going upwards because that boosts you. I don't know why. If you go up a slope like this and you just... Don't know why that works, but it does. Yep. Try not to get squished. That's actually very, 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 very important. That would be a shame, really. Dicks. Shit. I'm trying to help. Fuck. Rude. Like, I'm feeling like I want to leave. Like, this is... I feel like I'm being disrespected here. Severely disrespected. This is just... unfair. They're not being kind to me. Even though I came here with the best of intentions. Dicks. A lot of them. I swear. Anything? There's nothing we can have in here, no. I need to recheck it at times because I tend to forget. Here we go. Hallway of pain. There's another one on the right. Left, sorry. Now there's one on the right. There we go. Hold the right side, and then there's one on the left again. Yes. Steam! It hurts you a lot. Broken floors. Aha! Or is it? Just look around. Again, like, I know there's nothing here, but I have an unofficial patch, so they might change things. That's the reason I do this. Okay. And we're leaving. Shoo! And through this nice slow ass door. Thank you. Open. Thank you. Appreciate it. There we go. And then we just piss off, essentially. We're done here. We're out! Okay, I'll just give you a quick rundown of her diary here. Rest arrived here at the Ocean House. We have a week-long holiday here in Santa Monica. And Ed booked us a room for the hotel's grand opening. It's a wonderful place, almost magical. The children have been swimming all afternoon. The first 2 days had been almost perfect, except that Ed can't seem to stop asking about the locket I received from my mother. He seems to think it has sent to me by some other admirer. Ed can be sweet, but sometimes his jealousy can't get the better of him. Hopefully he'll feel better tomorrow. Sun is out today, not a cloud in the sky. Ed seems a little on edge, keeps guessing as to who my new boyfriend is. Silly Ed. There was a picnic for the hotel guests this morning, quite a grand affair. Ed is still in a dark mood. I don't know what I can do to reassure him that he is my one and only love. The only time he seemed to brighten up was when I was speaking to the groundskeeper. Boys and their tools. We only have 2 days left, and thank God we're finally going home. Ed won't speak to me or the children. And I found him more than once in the bathroom holding the locket and staring at it. I'm afraid he suffered some sort of breakdown. I've told him we can go home, but he just shakes his head. He won't look at me. I just want to go home. Ed left early this morning and I haven't seen him since. I haven't seen him in another hour. Like, I'm going to call the hotel manager. Against my better wishes, Ed Jr. went to look for him downstairs in the basement, which is where you send all your children. I'm going to send Tiffany down to fetch him. Someone's knocking at... Oh, that's bad. Oh my God! Ed's covered in blood coming to kill me, locked myself in the bathroom and it's gone crazy and is shouting we will get together forever and we'll never get together, someone... This is it. And then it goes dead. And that's the story. That's essentially the whole thing. Where have we heard that one before? I have no idea. Now we need to head all the way back to the club. Yay. Here we go. A little blood doll, if you want one. Blood dolls, essentially people you can seduce and get blood out of. Whatever. If you want to. You need seduction, and I don't have it. Please close the door and go upstairs. Thank you. Hopefully at this point my editing hasn't driven me insane, which it more than likely has. Okay, I'm gonna do that as well. I don't trust this game. Hello!
Not even a knock? I could have been undressing. And who knows what I would have had to do to you. You're here to see Her Royal Majesty Queen Victoria, aren't you?
What? I brought this for... I need to see Therese.
Therese is out making a show of how well her lips fit on the pants seat of the Camarilla. Did you happen to find her chastity belt or something?
I need to give something to Therese. It's from the hotel.
Ooh! Can I see it?
Don't give it to her. You will fail the quest. I'm not joking. Don't give it to her, no matter fucking what. No matter how pale her tits are. I don't know. I'd rather give it to Therese.
I'm not just some silly doll, you know.
Oh, I know.
All my life, my sister's made me out to be a joke.
I mean...
She told you I was an embarrassment, didn't she? That I couldn't tie my shoes, let alone hold on to something for her. Is that it?
I wouldn't give you the time of day, crazy bitch. No, please, calm down. I can't take this bullshit.
She's always belittling me. She's the smart one. She's the favorite. She's the successful one. Mm-hmm. Well, it's not fair. I'm not a fool. This club's success is just as much my doing as it is hers.
But this isn't yours. So, I mean, it's not mine or hers either. But still, I'm just saying. Would you stop? You're driving me nuts. I understand, but I can't give it to you.
Do you understand what it's like to have your own flesh and blood ripping you apart on a daily basis for two lifetimes? Can you?
Not really. I mean, but I really need to give this to someone.
Fine. You hold on to it.
Cool.
Since you are so willing to brave that big spooky place for my darling sister, how about doing a teensy tiny favor for little troubled me?
I mean, sure. What would put a smile on that face?
Do you know Gallery Noir down the street?
Yes.
I happen to know there's a charity event being organized there. Lots of influential Santa Monicans slithering in for token appearances. But there's one thing they don't know. The whole event's been set up by a kindred trying to establish their own power clique in our city. And we can't let that happen, can we? So I need some brilliant young upstart to spoil the milk.
Okay. What do I do?
I promise this won't take long. Take this knife. Give the paintings in the gallery a good slashing. Don't get caught, and don't turn it into a massacre. And steal the charity box, would you? Buy yourself something velvet.
Sweet. All right. Sure. I just want to see what everything else is. Okay.
I'm sure Therese will be thrilled to honor your agreement when you get back. But in the meantime, get to the museum and ruin those paintings. Then pay me a visit. I want to hear all about it. Hurry up. I can only amuse myself for so long.
Be back soon. Bye.
Oh, and there was something about the paintings.
Okay, we're leaving.
Shh. I can't remember.
I'm busy here. I'm trying to record shit. Exactly. That sounded worse for the fact that there's no music going on. Unless I'm being clever and find some royalty-free shit, which I probably haven't, because royalty-free music doesn't work either. So, there's that. And we're out. Finally, good lord. My brain at this point, editing must have been gone. Yes. You're right. Gallery Noir is this way. We need to head all the way over to the other side of town. Oops, sorry. This way, thank you. We need to head this way. You're gonna meet one of the people's like least favorite characters in the game, because he tends to break it a lot. Yep, there he is. Hey, buddy.
Hey, hold on a minute there. I'm afraid you're committing a 351.
Oh no.
Trespassing on private property. I'm gonna have to ask that you vacate the premises immediately, or I'm afraid I'll be forced to radio this in.
Didn't you get the call? One of the artists pissed off the director, so I'm here to pull shit from the show.
And who might you be then, Chief?
Oh, come on. I'm the museum director assistant. Think you can let me in? Like, come on, cut me some slack.
Yeah? That pay well?
Absolutely.
Look, I'll let you in, but I'll be filing a 62A on this when I get back to the security station after my shift.
Well, I'd expect it. Better file a 45B while you're at it, dude. Right?
might be. Anyway, go ahead on in and you have yourself...
Yeah, absolutely. Thank you very much. That is Chunk, ladies and gentlemen. One of the police officers that not many people here like. First order of business, steal this. You lose some humanity, but who gives a shit? Okay. So as you can see here, this is about God things. Like, if you know your Bible things, you know how this works. Plus, this is about vampires, so... It's basically Cain. The story of Cain, everybody should know this. Cain slays his brother. He then gets cursed by the god himself. He then meets the Lilith. Boop. And he then spams Lilith. There was something else you forgot to mention about the painting. This! Thank you. Oh dear. I want to get away with my things here. Thank you. Let's fight him. Ow. I could just blood buff him. Fuck it. Ow. Ah. That yellow thing. That yellow on our meter means that it doesn't heal as quick. But that's no problem. And we're done. Shazam. Now we leave and we head back to the club. Yay. Excellent. Excellent job. There's a glitch I kind of want to see if I can do here. Move. This is another blood doll. Let's see. There will be... Oh, come on.
You. What were you thinking?
I did it. Yay. It's a pointless glitch, but... Whatever.
The museum. That was my event. Did you think I wouldn't find out?
Sorry.
Shut up. I thought I could control my sister as long as Tongue was out of the picture. But nothing's changed. I should have expected that you'd succumb to Jeanette's influence like all the others. But how dare you?
I swear we didn't do it. It was the...
Jeanette claimed you did it for her. But let's say I believe you. After all, you've acted decently and rationally up to now. I imagine you'd still like me to call off the feud.
Yes, I have something for you.
Excellent.
Yes.
I'll take that. However...
What?
There's only one problem.
Uh-huh.
If Tongue gets word that I threatened Jeanette, which he most certainly already has, it's not likely he'll believe me.
Well.
So, in order to call off the feud, you're going to have to convince Jeanette to forgive me first.
Okay. Sure.
I made some threats against my sister.
Mm-hmm.
Idle threats. Right. Involving fire and her impious satin sheets.
Right.
She took them quite seriously and is avoiding me. I want to meet with her and explain that they were said in the heat of the moment. I asked her to meet me at the Surfside Diner to reconcile, but I'm busy with the club and my other endeavors. I'd like you to go to the diner and promise her that I don't plan to take any action against her. Wait for her in the back booth near the phones.
Absolutely.
For all her unwholesome diversions and irritating disruptions, I should be less tolerant of her. She is my sister, however, and I suppose I'm obligated to forgive her trespasses. I did sire her, after all. Please, be quick about it.
Right then. Sorry about phasing through your floor as well. That was sort of awkward of me. I do apologize so very much. Right, now we need to head over to the diner, which is across the street. So... Boop. We're almost done with this fucking area. Are we? We have one big area left. The reason we're doing all this from the start anyway, so. Alright. Back to the diner. Gentlemen. I'm sure everything will be absolutely fine here. Or will it? Wait for it. One of them will come. One of them will. Don't worry about it. It'll be fine! Oh god. This could be very bad. One of them usually gets up to me so I can, like, suck blood from him and then you murder fuckers. There's Bloodstrike. See if this works. Dead. Fly, bitch. Haha. There we go. Always punch them before you drink blood from them. It helps. It actually does help a lot. There we go. I have about the same amount of blood as when I got in him. Sweet. Pick up the pistols. We can sell these. It, like, they're not good pistols. You, if you need pistols, you'll get better later. Don't worry about it. Right then.
I'm terribly sorry about that. My sister was just furious about your refusal to take part in her designs. So she sent those men to kill you. But I'm going to make sure it never happens again.
Mm-hmm.
We'll take care of this
tongue. Likely story.
She's crazy! Help!
Right. This is where things start to come together. Like, you're like, oh, I get it. Like, there's some things you needed to have noticed about her at this point, really. Alright. This time we can't phase through the floor, but it'll work. I'll make it work. Anyway, somehow. Okay. I like the fact that when you go upstairs, the actual music goes quiet. Well, not quiet. Not off, but it goes quieter. But it's still audible. So, and of course... Every time it freezes like that, I freak out a little bit. Right.
You. I'm really sorry it had to end this way. I truly am. You seemed promising, but you've been tainted by the stink of my sister's schemes. And now I'm going to make sure she never double-crosses me again. Don't listen to her. She'll kill us both. Save me and I'll help you find Bertram, I swear. Shut up, Jeanette! I warned you to stay away from Tongue. He's turned you against me. I always looked out for you, but you couldn't stand my success. You had to meddle, didn't you? I didn't want it to end like this, but you forced me! You never gave me any credit for anything, Therese. I was the one calling the shots. Bertram was dancing on my leash. How does it feel to know that I beat you?
I mean, the things, they're like, it was there all, the whole time. Like, if you look at their eyes, like, one blue, one green. The painting, I don't know if I showed you it. No, I didn't. Shit. But it has, like, her and her sister, and then a dude in the middle, and their father in the middle. So there's that. Why are you both fighting?
Isn't it obvious? I'm about to rid the knight of this deviant, backstabbing whore. Do you realize that despite her condition, she still fornicates with kine, no less? So despicable. So unclean. You're one to talk, dear sister. Or should I say daddy's little girl? Do you want to know just how depraved the Baron of Santa Monica can be? Shut up, Jeanette. You'd love the world to think you're a saint. When you thought I was asleep, I used to hear Father come in at night. I heard him whisper how much he loved you in your ear before he... Don't finish that sentence, or you're dead.
So basically, here is where you can either find out the full story on what actually happened to that story, or you could just... save both of them. You can either, if you don't have enough persuasion, you basically have to kill one, or you don't have to kill them, but you have to pick one. So there's that. But you can tell what this is about. Like, come on, it's obvious.
Don't you want to hear what happened? How she became the pillar of the community she is today?
I can figure it out.
Just shut up!
Stop it right now, the both of you!
Don't try and stop me. I've had to overlook her treachery. Her seduction, relations with my enemies, and the consequences of it. But I won't endure her any longer. Endure me? Dear sister, you've done everything you could to smother me. You'd love to bury me in your closet, along with all your other skeletons. I'm the good girl. You're the wicked one. You've done nothing but plot against me, when I had our best interests at heart. And despite that, I've always covered up your mistakes. I've taken care of you. And this is how you repay me? Taken care of me. You've done nothing but keep me down. Blame me for every mistake. Did you expect me to let you rule my life until the end of time? No, sister. You've had it coming since our last sunrise. Is that right, dear? If it wasn't for me, you would have never survived this long. Remember? They tried to separate us, but I refused. I chose this life and brought you into it so that we could stay together. Obviously, you've forgotten.
Basically, a little bit of a wibbly wobbly moment going on here, so yeah.
She's a control freak. People, things, emotions. If she can't control something, she gets rid of it. And you're a wild animal.
Makes sense to me.
You'll rub up against anything that'll take you in for the night. Then when you're stuffed and bored, you bite the hand that fed you.
Well, both of you have been working against the other. Together, you'd be a power. A mega power. Ooh, yeah.
I don't think that's possible. How could I ever think to trust her again? Trust me? Who could trust you after what happened with Father Dearest? Father loved me. I was a good girl. I always did what I was told. You always hated that he loved me. You disobeyed him. You brought men home when he wasn't there. You were an awful daughter to him.
That's all in the past. Forget about it, eh? Come on.
Father came home drunk one day and mistook me for Therese. Because I'd fallen asleep in her bed. Don't listen to her. She's lying. Therese walked in while he was there, and she saw me lying with him, and so she went to the closet and pulled out his hunting shotgun, loaded it with deer shot, and blew his mind out all over the silly clown wallpaper. That's a lie. Father killed himself because of Jeanette. She made him miserable. As I recall, he died with a smile on his face.
Well, no matter what happened, you two need each other to move on and such nonsense.
Why? How will this time be any different?
Here's where it could be kind of funny. You're both crazy, that's why. You're both in the same body. Think about what she just said about her sister. She basically fucks everybody. They're in the same body. It's kind of funny. It's funny for her reaction. But what you need to do is press 3.
Therese doesn't like to share. Jeanette's irresponsible. She's undependable. A venture like mine requires class and distinction, which is something a pigtailed face-painting harlot does not lend very well. You do have a way with words, sister. You're right. I'm not in the same class, am I? I mean, murderers are so respectful these days.
Therese, let Jeanette have more responsibility.
More responsibility?
Yes.
So that she can ruin every opportunity I give her? Of course.
Sure.
You're the only one who can secure zoning permits and shake hands. I'd never be able to keep up.
She actually has a point. Jeanette, stop sabotaging your sister's plan. What button did I hit? That was a bad move. I don't know what just happened, but whatever.
But I only do it for attention and out of love. You do it because you're vindictive and jealous, and you deserve it.
You know what I forgot to tell you before now? You can actually turn subtitles on, but it goes up in like the corner, like upper left corner, and it sucks. This thing you see here, like the yellow bit, that's me actually like clicking the left mouse. That's way easier than that, because the original text, like, it lags behind. It's so bad. Anyway, if you call a truce and run this place equally, there's no need to kill each other.
If she would stop treating me like a child, if she would start behaving like a rational adult.
Both very good points.
Yes, there was a time. When I was a child, I didn't have many friends. I suppose Jeanette was the only one. We never did get to go out of the house much.
She didn't
Father
have friends.
Wouldn't allow us. He said
we'd
get hurt, so we stayed inside and we imagined our own
world. Big surprise, I mean.
And we spent so much time there together, ruling over those places. Those were happier times, before we grew apart.
Oh, what a shame. You don't want to have an office harder, do you?
I never did. No, I guess I don't. Jeanette, if I were to offer you equal control in Santa Monica, would you quit consorting with Tung? I'll stop working against you with him. But since I've got him in my pocket already, there's no reason for me not to pay him a little visit once in a while. When he
Good
can
point.
Be of use,
that's
she actually
not has
a bad
point.
Plan.
Yeah, see?
There's just one more thing. I want to be in charge of Santa Monica, but only publicly. I want you to continue to convince others that our relations are strained. That way, we know who our enemies are. I agree.
Can you tell they started finishing each other's sentences?
Take it. I'd hate to look at it again and think of what almost transpired. I suppose now that Jeanette and I have settled our differences, I'll call off the feud with Tung. Bertram's
Excellent.
Hiding in an empty oil tank at the old gas station. I'll tell him to expect a visitor, and I'll ask him to be extra nice.
Thank you.
Please give Santa Monica's regards to the prince. And keep your tongue tied about what happened tonight, or we'll have to kill you.
Kill you. Done. And then they sort of throw us out. We can go back in, but why would you want to? You're done with that place. All right. There. Right in that little place, right there. That's where he is. We're done here, right? Yep. Yo, sweetie. This guy, you can get a ton of information, and I recommend you actually do that, because he knows a lot about each, every single different clan, and every person. Like, it's a Nosferatu, that's what they do, information. So I suggest you actually do it yourself. I'm not gonna, because like I said before, it's gonna take time.
But don't bother with the introductions, fledgling. I know who you are.
I also like his voice, it's cool. You do?
News travels down the Kindred grapevine like wildfire. And that courtroom spat between LaCroix and Nines Rodriguez is a juicy little morsel. And you in the middle. How interesting.
So you're saying you heard it through the grapevine? Sorry. That's great! So you know I need to get to that warehouse, yes?
I've been watching the place.
Uh-huh.
The Sabbat has a bunch of low-life humans working day and night to move stuff through there. There's some major staging going on.
A big deal happening. Right, can you get me inside?
Yes, I can.
Cool.
Just tell me when you're ready, and we'll leave. Once you're there, however, you're on your own. You'll have to get into the place and plant the explosives in the middle office to take the whole structure down.
Deal. Let's go. Yay, we're off. Final area. Here we go. It lagged on me and I got scared. I don't have anything useful on me, right? No. I have a shotgun, but I rarely use weapons. There's like one or two occasions, maybe. There's one that I... no, not even then. Fuck! Didn't work. There it worked. What? No! What are you doing? I didn't press anything. There. Good, now it works. Erotic sounds from an erotic man. Sure, I'll get the tire iron. Why not? Fuck it. And then there's bullets here. Like I said, I don't use the bullets, but there it's there. Oh, I thought it was someone there and got a weird look. What? There's not supposed to be anyone here. There's gonna be a guy in here as well. He will probably see us as well, maybe. I think. Because we have no stealth. Nope! Sucker! Take the pistol. Get out through here instead so we don't have to waste blood. Whoop. There's a bum in case you wanna chew on bums, I guess. Now we leave. Hi, what's up? See it. Yep. There we go. And we're good. Here's where you can get things interesting. You can either, like, sneak past everyone or just mash him in the head, essentially. I'm gonna do the easier path by just walking around them, because that's what I tend to do. Be a sneaky bastard. But there will be murder. Don't worry about that part. There will be death. Just not me, essentially. So, because that's a pretty important thing. Right, let's see here. Let's see if this thing works. Where's my thing? Balls! Ah! Oh! Yeah, it works! Awesome! That's a bad move. That's a bad move. Really bad move, in fact. Move, shitbag! Move! Like, look at this. I can't... There. Finally, good lord. There we go! Numb on him until the other guys come in and shoot me. Thank you. None of these guys actually matter. Some of them may, but... Okay, let's just... Yeah, okay. Nope, apparently not. Okay, cool. Would you fucking piece of shit doors? Good lord. Okay. See if we can get him up here. Or not, whatever. There's gonna be more people in here. Hi. Dick. You gonna come in? You coming in? Oh, god damn it. Coming in? Good, I'm coming out. No! Dick! Shit! Fuck, that could have been real bad. That was actually really horrible. I think I'll stay here and just regenerate a little bit of health. So, bear with me for a little moment. Okay. We're not gonna plant things yet, don't worry about it. We're gonna see if I can't... Where's my trance? There's nobody here. Shit. There's usually a guy here. God damn it. Fuck. Okay. That puts me in an awkward position because now I have to run through a lot of shit with a little bit of health. Fuck it. I've already autosaved, quick saved, so it'll be fine. And here we go. Don't worry, I have the time. That was excellent timing. Funny thing happening in about 3 seconds. That guy you just saw, he's actually, as he's coming through the door, he's not actually a solid object, so he's sort of not really there. Funny thing you can do. That didn't work. Fuck. You can actually jump on that box and then get in. Thank you. Right. You jump on that box and he essentially... You get launched. Now we need to fight this guy. He's not so bad. Get up on the box. Because that way we can juggle you. Yay. Hello? Wow. Nice flip. Get up. Ow. Dick. No. There we go. Excellent. Now we can leave. As you can see, we have like... plenty of time. There should be an ammo box around here. If I'm not mistaken. Ah, whatever. Fuck it all. We're leaving. We're meeting with one of my all-time favorite characters ever. There we go. I don't know why I'm collecting it. Like, it's not worth much. But, you know, whatever. Yeah, plenty of time to get through. Alright. Let me introduce my favorite character ever.
The warehouse. Your handiwork, I presume?
Yeah, that was me.
Hopefully no Sabbat saw you escape.
Good point.
Somewhat antagonistic.
A little bit. Have you been following me?
I see my reputation for once.
For once, does not precede me.
My name is Beckett.
Beckett!
I haven't been following you per se. We've just coincidentally been at the same places at the same time.
It makes sense, I guess. Alright.
So sorry if I unnerved you.
It's fine.
Have you by chance seen or felt anything strange since your embrace?
Well, no. Do
Most
that.
Most of my contacts here report sensing something unusual in the night air. Like a sense of dread or pressure. But I'm not a native to these parts, so I can't tell if it's irregular. And since you're still fresh, perhaps you're not attuned to it.
That could be it, indeed, yes.
Pleasure meeting your acquaintance.
Thank you, sir.
For me to discredit. We shall, I'm certain, meet again.
Alright.
Or never again. Good night, young one.
Night.
And be careful. You're very likely being hunted by the Sabbat.
Ooh. Night, Beckett. Bye, Beckett. He's just a really cool dude, I guess. Let's tell him about it.
Nice work, Fledgling. I felt that explosion.
Thank you.
Away. It's all over the news, too. Man, there's gonna be some pissed off Sabbat just howling for blood tonight.
Do you know someone named Beckett?
Beckett? Well, I know of him. Why?
Had a quick word with the guy.
No kidding.
Nope.
Must be something major happening if he's in town. Beckett is right. A historian of sorts. He's unearthed more vampire lore than anyone. Well, that's all Beckett does. Seek the truth behind our condition.
Seems actually pretty cool. Bertram, I have some serious questions for you. No, I do not.
You better
Bye.
Get back downtown.
Yep.
Prince LaCroix is going to want to hear all about this victory.
Yep, absolutely. We'll go do that right now. We're actually... basically at the end of our little thing here, so yeah, so I'm gonna do this before, because this game has, like I said, has a tendency to go so there's that.
Where to?
You wanna know a funny thing? This guy, that guy, everybody has a theory on the guy. Like, oh, that's Kane, that's the head guy, that's the big good. And such, because of the things he says in the future. You'll hear it, don't worry. Just drive. Downtown, please! Cutscene. I think.
Keep moving. Trouble sure seems to like you. Good effort. Execution needs a little work. You look like shit. Name's Nines.
Thanks for the help, sir.
Should have been more careful, Luby.
Well,
the burbs.
I can tell. I'll remember that. I'll remember you from the court thing.
Kid, I got things to deal with.
Uh-huh.
Why don't you pay me a visit at the last round tonight?
Right.
I don't know what you've heard so far, but it's
not much.
The real story.
Of course, everyone has their version of the story. I'll do that.
This is a mean existence. Stay out of trouble, kid.
I promise absolutely nothing. And here... can I do my thing now? Thank you. And here we are, ladies and gentlemen. Downtown. Woo! And this is where I'll be cutting it off for this episode. Thank you guys very much for watching for about 2 hours now. And yeah, hopefully you've enjoyed it so far. I sure as hell have. I can play this many times over. I don't care. Like, it's fun to me. But anyway, thank you guys very much for watching this episode. I'll be back later with even more Vampire the Masquerade Bloodlines. See you then, folks. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss the next episode. Trust me, it's gonna be a fucking good one. I promise. Maybe I shouldn't promise that. But whatever. I'll see you then, folks. Bye. Bye.